Tazadak, we can't hear you.
So we can hear you. We can hear you. So it seems like, sis, what you're trying to push here is androgyny. And androgyny is a method that Satan uses, right?
No, not androgyny.
Let me finish. Because I'm listening to what you're saying. Because Universe was right when I put you on this side, because you said that there was nothing. And then when I showed you that why there was something, then you tap dance around it, and then you started going on another point. And so this is what Satan does, right? Satan uses androgyny to attempt to conquer all, right? And so the androgyny is that he try to emphasize the equality of both sexes. And that's what you're trying to do. And now with your last statement, you're trying to make it seem, let me finish. You're trying to make it seem as though I'm saying women are not important. We're not saying that at all. We never said that. See, hold on. Let me finish. Because that's the stance that women take when we say something that they're not in agreement with. They, instead of listening to the rationale in it, they take it as an attack on women. But the fact of the matter is, the Most High is a man, and he created man, right? So to govern everything, right? Now, I challenge all of these women that say otherwise to show me any civilization, unless it was mythological, that was ran by women. Show me when the world was dominated by women. You see, it's that way for a reason. Men's been ruling since the beginning of time for a reason, because he was given dominion, and he's supposed to rule in the Most High's absence. The Most High put him on this earth to rule and made him to have dominion over everything on this earth, inclusive of the woman. Women like to say you can't get here without coming through her womb, right? She also experiences tremendous pain for that, as a reminder of a punishment of disobeying the Most High. She undergoes a great deal of pain each time she brings forth birth. And some of them get these sedatives, these drugs to try and lessen the pain. But what I'm hearing is like a psycho-theological mechanism that really seems to function as an androgynous person. See, and what they do, when someone's involved in, androgyny, it's like whether they're homosexual, bisexual, they're able to express within themselves both sexual roles and identities. And this is what you keep trying to do. Well, see, in the sex act, they engage both as male and female. This is what androgyny is all about, right? It's equally, and this is what women keep trying to do. They try to make us their equal, but we're not. We're physically stronger. We have capacity to do many other things that she can't do. We're physically stronger. We can have baby after baby after baby with different women. The Creator made us that way for a reason. It's a gift that you women keep trying to come along and deprive us of because of your emotions, and you don't have that capacity. Well, there's a reason that you don't have that capacity. Well, but you keep trying to tap into this androgyny. Well, yeah, male and female. Yeah, we need both males and females, but the male is the dominant factor, and he's the leader. He's the head. Well, where's this noise coming from, man? This noise is coming.
Working as a nurse for many, many years, it was really draining me. Lagi akong pagod at exhausted.
Marty, I guess. Or maybe it's her. Let me mute that. So, now, the whole androgyny concept is what Satan does. He told the woman, think about this. He told the woman, your eyes will come open and you will be as God. Adam, the Ish, was already made as the Most High, because he was made in his image and likeness, and he was given dominion to rule the entire earth just like the Most High. So he rules in the Most High's absence. But Eve wanted that same thing. So notice the tempter didn't go to Adam. He went to her. Why? Because she didn't have those same capacities. She wanted to be a god. See, man was made in the image and likeness of the Most High. The woman was made in the image and likeness of man. Man is the glory of the Most High, but woman is the glory of man. See, there's not an equality right there. The Most High didn't make it that way. It was that way for a reason. See, men, we're not equal, huh? So, but when you bring in this androgyny and keep trying to say we're equal, equally as penetrators and penetrated, that's not the same. It's not the same. See, it's the hard and the soft. It's the law of nature. You have the hard, you have the soft. You have the hot, you have the cool. Man is the hard. The woman is the soft. She's supposed to be the soft. She's trying to be the hard. It's a reason that a woman's vajayjay is soft. She's the soft. It's a reason that a man's rod is hard. He's the hard. And thus, taste in some form or other, both physically and spiritually, this androgyny keeps coming in. But spiritually, they have the physical plane joined in opposites. See, we're opposites. Proven and experiencing that there is a distinction. But with androgyny, they're trying to tell you that there's no distinction between man and woman, that they're equal. But there's just distinctions according to the Most High. There's just distinctions. The Creator created distinctions. So androgyny, that I keep hearing from you, because I'm listening to what you're saying, you keep saying the male and the female, the male and the female. But yeah, we're opposites. We're not the same. We have different purposes. We have different purposes. The Creator made distinctions within us, man. So androgyny, in various forms, literally eradicates the distinction, which is why you keep bringing it in. That's what Satan does. He brings in androgyny, meaning, well, it's male and female. It's male and female. It's male. But yeah, there's distinctions in the male and females. But, and so what this androgyny does, it causes confusion of the human mindset with the divine. Right? The distinction elevates the spiritual blending. Of all things. All things has distinctions. That's what makes it great. That's what makes it so great. And this seems to be very, this is the logic that the Apostle Paul brings in the book of Romans 1 and 18 through 27. That's what Paul was talking about. But this modern secular androgyny is just more of a variant of pagan thinking. That's all it really is. This is why when the good brother Universal Sovereign Soul was saying, well, where's this coming from? You can explain it because it's paganistic. It's paganistic. It's the spiritual mindset that the Apostle Paul speaks of in the book of Romans 1 and 18. And it's found in just about any world view that collapse. And this is what happens when you collapse the Creator. You say you believe in the Creator. You really don't. You collapse the Creator's distinction. See, the Creator created us distinctively different. Men and women are distinctively different. When you bring in androgyny, you're trying to make us the same, but we're not. And that's the essence of Satan's desire, is to try and make us equal, because that goes against the divine patriarchy that the Most High set up in this earth. You cannot collapse this distinction without further collapsing all other distinctions that depend upon it. I digress. That's what I'm saying.